single team entering play. They come in on a pretty good roll here, winners of three straight.
And last week's win was indicative of how good this team can be. It was a complete performance.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the they'll try and start this drive in the air. Then it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that. Second down.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test him early. But it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again.
This one complete to Jalen Waddle.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. He'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that. Second down. Line of scrimmage again to 37 as they line up second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw.
Swinging this out for Pollard.
And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys are real extra pain in their step. You go to them early. Not quite sure that they envision a much better...
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
Well, this defense for the Bengals, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
Yeah, they gave up 17 points, but that's what you would consider a goal for each and every defense, because if you give up 17 points a game all year long, you're thinking you're going to be a playoff team because you expect your offense to score more than that. That's what you're looking for. Room to improve, of course, but I'd have to say a very solid performance.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw.
Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted.
Picked off by Mike Hilton.
And the Bengals are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
So a first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 5 catches, 90 yards.
Better tighten up the coverage if you expect to slow this guy down, because if he gets going, he'll eat you up.
Second and 5. Throw across his body, and it's intercepted.
Picked by Logan Wilson. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football.
Ethan.
So cancel the interception, pass interference.
And you know what else gets canceled? The return yardage. Makes the play, but now it's all for naught.
On first down, he'll drop to throw.
That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw.
Oh, that's
gets into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And the Bengals are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line.
Is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And going deep for Hill. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Now an open man. That's the tight end, Gesicki. It's complete. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And able to find Gesicki as tight end. It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 25 yards that time. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll look to throw again. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 12-yard line. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The Dolphins moving with a sense of urgency here. On play action, they'll throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving them a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and it seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And this is going to be intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick, and the Bengals are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Yep, no score, so.
Now a play fake here on first down. And his throw here is incomplete.
They certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. He'll be out of bounds right at the 40. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. They'll look to throw. Completes it to the tight end, Smythe. Call it a gain of 3 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Well, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the...
And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Tyreek Hill, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins have got it back to within a score. At the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And now 2 yards to go on third down. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Well, with him trailing here in the second half, maybe his legs can try to give this offense a spark.
And that's the benefit of having a young quarterback, right? Having a rookie, a guy who will say, hold on a second, I have a little bit of fearlessness to my game. It isn't working as well the other way. Let's see what I can do to help my team this way. And boy, he did it there.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
Deep ball there on second down.
Absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try and get those yards a safer way.
He's got his tight end. It's Mike Gesicki. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 39. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Throw here to his running back, and he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. Coming up on second and 7. Back to throw again. And this is caught, and he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash, dropped at the 1. It's a gain of 35.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
And he is in. Touchdown, Miami. A great effort there. With his 13th touchdown of the year and 2nd of the game. And the Dolphins are back with... Try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, he's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards. They go play action here on first down. On the move to it. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And the Bengals are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. On the last drive. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. He'll look to throw. He is going to find Hill here. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. That catch now puts him on the doorstep of 500. It's his 499th reception. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back now in Cincinnati. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is caught. Touchdown, Dolphins.
Jalen Waddle,
62 yards.
And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. And what a...
throw now on first down. They're going deep for Hill. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete.
And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path, a significant number.
Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Now a second down and 6.
Back to throw. And he's got him. Got his man on the end route. Complete. A looming decision to make on the conversion. Down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. He'll look to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Trey Hendrickson in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Third and goal. And keep in mind, very possibly 4-down territory.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he's not able to get away. Saves back at the 22. Trey Hendrickson able to drop him that time for his second. He'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Clemson product, DJ Reader, got in for the sack. A nickel look now for the Bengals as they try to stop him here on third down. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining.